fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the DePaul Blue Demons and the Marquette Golden Eagles. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
We have two excellent players matched at the point guard position. It's going to be interesting to watch how they each try to get their team involved throughout the game. Hey, you talk about a hot baby. You talk about a rivalry that's really keen. Well, this rivalry between these two teams has become so fierce over the years. Hey, the students have been camping out for days. And get ready for this one. You won't find an empty seat here tonight.
You said it, Dick. It's going to be wild in here tonight. He takes the three. Missed it. In the post. In the lane. Scores it. He can put points up, and he can move the ball.
What's great about him is his ability to pass and score. It's a skill that not enough guards have. As a coach, you love having this type of player on your roster.
He shoots from the top of the circle and score it. Ball didn't even seem like it touched the floor there.
Well, a lot of offense really depends on ball movement. And when you get reversals like this, good things always happen.
Gave it up. He puts up the J. Bust the J.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Kane receives the pass. Puts up the J. Jumper won't go. Howard receives the ball. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. I'm with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Takes away the pass.
Trying to go inside.
Tries for two. Off the glass. Blocks the shot. Howard handles the feed.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket, he hits it.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
On the wing for two. Not there. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Nope.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Sinks it.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Goes up for two. He gets it to fall.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Here's a double team. Way out on the right wing from right of the circle.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Bust the jumper. Reed is recognized as a player who can do it all down there on the low block.
I tell you, he's definitely what I would call a complete post. He can do many different things and really puts pressure on the defense.
That's the luxury of the home court advantage. You have the crowd chanting, jumping around, fired up. It is awesome.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He bombs from outside. Missed the jumper. Feed. Takes the jumper. The missed shot. Zone offense now. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
And come up short. On the outside. He pulls up with a jumper. Off the mark. Both teams looking to get things going here. Inside. Tries for two. Missed it. On the dribble, gives it up. Number two picks up the foul. First personal foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all. Trying to execute on the inbounds. Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
They work it around the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta. All these missed shots. I don't even think they're giving the ball a chance to go in there.
They couldn't hit the ocean with a beach ball right now, Brad. That was some of my players. That's why I got fired. What an embarrassment.
Dumps it in. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Can't connect. And the slam. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside. But they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Bust the J. Dick at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
He goes up with it. They get it to go. Looking for a good shot. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Out on the left wing. He attempts a jump shot. Nails a sweet jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two. That's good. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when the team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. lot of teams will play this offense.
And we're at the 8-minute mark. Gave it up. With the fadeaway. He misses the fadeaway. Sinks the shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Great shot. Looking for a good shot. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Howard handles the feed. He shoots from right of the circle.
Excellent jump shot right there.
These two rivals keeping it close here in the first half.
Hey, both these teams are playing strong, but most importantly, they're remaining focused. Emotions tend to run high in games like this, so the key is to stay focused.
He strokes it, nails the jumper. He puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. He nails the bucket. Both teams looking to get things going here. About 6 minutes remaining. Working it around the perimeter. Launches away. Perfectly executed. Reed receives the pass. As the fans chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Zone offense now. They'll bring it back out on top and reset it.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. I hate it when guys can't make that entry. They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Count that as a personal foul. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
I tell you, it's been a treat to watch him out there. He understands what he needs to do, which occasionally means taking a shot, and at other times looking for his teammate.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Hey, underclassmen are an important part of any program. With a year under his belt, the coaching staff expects solid play from him.
He hits his first. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. They've got him trapped. 5 minutes left in the game clock, and they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
On the left side. Number two is called for the foul. Number 21 comes back out onto the floor.
Major swing in energy with him back on the floor, Brad.
Opportunity now for an easy one. Misses the first. He misses the second. Gives it up. with the J. And score it. Great job of occupying the high post, which ultimately leads to a scoring opportunity.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Goes up with a shot. Missed the jumper. The shooting guard receives the ball. Unloads. Doesn't go.
There's the trap.
Nails the J. Moving it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Drains the shot. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Two. Tickles a twine. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
About 3 minutes remaining on the left side. On the outside, he launches a three. Scorches the net with a J. Kane handles the feed with a little baby hook. The missed shot, swatted away. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion on the right side. Scores it. Reed handles the feed, gave it up with a jumper. Knocks it down. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
The Golden Eagles coaching staff is extremely happy with the current tempo of the game. They've been encouraging their players to play that up-tempo style. Expect for the hectic and aggressive play to continue.
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. In the paint. Jumper won't go.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Tries for two, knocks it down. About a minute remaining. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Off the mark. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
The dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Golden Eagles go into their zone motion now. Here they come with a double team to stop it. The point guard gets the ball. For the bucket, he hits the shot. Shot clock is dead. Two. He makes the shot. The Blue Demons are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball into the high post puts pressure on the defense.
At halftime, the Golden Eagles are up by one. Here's a look at what each team here today will be focusing on when we get things underway.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Number two is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
EA, Aaron Andrews, standing by with an update regarding the rivalry. Aaron?
Both coaches had similar takes at the half. They want their team to start the second half as if the score is 0-0. They both insisted that that approach, that mentality, is what you have to start the second half.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. Come up short.
There it is, Jam City.
Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts, you can run screens, you can run back screens, you can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
Goes up for two. It's good. That's a good pass right there, Dick. This young guy is about distributing the basketball.
I'll tell you what, the thing that a lot of people don't understand is that you need guys on the roster who aren't always looking to score.
Puts up the jumper. Missed the jumper. On the right side. Too much. That's a foul.
You know, seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
Makes his first. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Left him a nylon, MBN.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. The Golden Eagles move into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key in the zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Gave it up. He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. On the left side. Three-point range. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
Kane receives the ball.
Up and inside.
He tries the jumper. Can't connect. They'll work it around the arc. He pulls up with a jumper. They get it to go. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Nope. From beyond the arc. Bust the J. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed it. Out on the wing. They work it around the perimeter. Unloads a three. Jumper won't go. He gets it to go. Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the dribble, gives it up. And the ball is saved. Great job. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. And a momentary look from three-point land. The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
The student section looks like they're having a great time.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
The Golden Eagles are on the run. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Cross court. Tries for two. The layup is good. And now getting set up here to four around one.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior. Look at that spacing.
Jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Zone offense now. He wants a three. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
They work the perimeter. For the bucket, perfectly executed. How about the great job of getting to the basket right there, Dick?
He had one thing on his mind, and that was getting to the goal. Mission accomplished. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. He goes up with it. Nails a sweet jumper. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today.
For two, buried it. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Kane handles the pass. Goes up. The missed shot. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. There's a double team waiting there. Gets the J to fall. Number 10 takes the feed. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. He comes up empty. He buries the shot. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you've got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
The Golden Eagles have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Number two is charged with the foul. Third personal foul. Once again, let's take a look at our star watch. We've got two rivals here. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews. Aaron, I got to think not the same feeling that we had in that first half that was so tightly contested.
Guys, emotions down here on the court are a lot different than they were in the first half. Players have towels over their heads. Frustrations are starting to mount, and it looks like this one could be blown wide open.
Thanks, Aaron. Defensive glass.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
The Golden Eagles have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
Tries for two, and he misses the shot. Gave it up. The Golden Eagles have a player spotting up on the three. Escapes a trap.
Great job of beating the trap there, Brian.
For the bucket. Oh, yes. On the outside. Takes his jumper. And score it. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can't play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
And we're at the eight-minute mark. Top of the circle, they're working around the perimeter. Trying to feed inside. He pulls the trigger. In and out. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. He tries to knock down the three and come up short. Number 10 receives the pass. Puts up the J. Knocks it down. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
For two. Off the glass and no good. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Howard is really turning some heads right now. He's on fire.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. They get it to go. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Looking to move it around the perimeter. We're at the 6 minute mark.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Goes up for two. He drains the shot. On the right side. The Golden Eagles move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Rejected. Buries it home. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Nick?
He had one thing on his mind, and that was getting to the goal. Mission accomplished.
He attempts a jump shot. They've really been looking good from three-point land so far.
Hey, man, oh, man, they've got the three ball dropping. It's been a lot of fun to watch. Watch for things to open up inside now that they've caught fire from the outside. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe. It's those free throws can. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
For a good shot. For the bucket. Goes in.
The D has no energy left on offense.
Their life is being sucked out of them right now on the defensive end. Working it around the perimeter. From the top of the key. Nope. For two. Goes. Moving it around the perimeter. He puts up the J. And nice looking jumper in the lane. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. There's a slam. Down to the low block, try to work inside. Bust the jumper. The shooting guard receives the pass. Goes up with a shot. Busts the J. The small forward takes the feed. He makes the block. Howard handles the pass. The Golden Eagles now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
Well, it's simple. They came out, executed their game plan, and ended up on top.
On the outside with a deep shot from outside. Knocked it down. Now getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility to step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Tries for two for the bucket.
What a terrific play, though, to tip that ball back. The awareness, the basketball IQ.
About 2 minutes remaining. He shoots the jumper. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
The perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Zone motion now. Out on the wing. Tries one from three-point land. Scorches the net with a J.
Up and inside.
From the corner. Jumper won't go. Working around the arc.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
He tries the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from left of the circle. They got it. The Blue Demons get some good ball reversal there.
Hey, when each player on offense touches the ball on the perimeter, it forces the defense to move. Eventually, the defense will break down.
With the J for the bucket. Nice shot. He shoots from the corner. Off the mark. Shot clock is dead. The Golden Eagles now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Nick, all the hype and hoopla prior to this rivalry game, and it didn't pan out the way we expected, really.
Well, everybody was really keyed up, expecting a great game, but they got the great start early, and that was it. It was blowout city.